الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we repent to Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. I bear witness that there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. They bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the series of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, today inshallah we want to start the new ethics, which is al-istighfar, which is supplicating for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has his beautiful names, Al-Ghafoor, Al-Ghaffar, Waghafir al-Dhanb. This is from his beautiful names, Al-Ghafoor, Al-Ghaffar, and Ghafir al-Dhanb. So there is a difference between these beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek in forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. You cannot seek forgiveness from anybody else. Only the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Ghafoor, is the one who will forgive you over and over and over. Whenever you commit a sin, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. So never give up. Whatever sin you commit, of course you try to avoid. As soon as you know, you realize that you committed a sin, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. And you keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put that in your heart to stay away from the sin. Never give up. There's different between al-ghafoor wal-ghaffar, wa-ghafir al-dhanb. Al-ghaffar, one of the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the one who will show the beauty and he will hide the ugliness. He will forgive you and show the goodness in you and will hide the bad in you from the sins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hide all your sins, so nobody will know when you ask him for forgiveness, when you not to do any sins as you can, but always come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. So Ghafoor, that's kind of a perfection of forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Ghafoor to forgive you. And when you keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, it has benefits. You get rewards when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish the people as long as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with them, or when they ask for forgiveness. There's two things. So now what we have is to ask for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us and will not punish us. Yes. So istighfar, you asking for forgiveness, and that forgiveness is basically to cover your sins and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to wipe it or to forgive it. So you get reward when you ask for forgiveness. There's difference between al-ghufran wal-afu. So al-ghufran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will drop the punishment. And you will get rewards for asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And only the believer get that. So the punishment will be dropped. You will get reward for asking for forgiveness. And as a believer, get that. And only this between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot do, you cannot have any human between you and any other human to ask for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who forgive. But al-afu, al-afu, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will drop the repentance, you'll drop the regrets, and and also, but you, it's like you are not, it's not there. Whatever you commit, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the reason that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, especially in the day of the night decree, the decree of the night of power, Laylatul Qadr, when Sayyidah Aisha asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam what to supplicate, اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعفو عنا العفو. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always for afu. But al-afu is more than forgiveness. But you, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have afu in you, it's going to wipe out all your sins. Even the angels will not remember. It's not like you did nothing. But also, al-mahw, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase all your sins. When you keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for al-afu, forbearance, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to erase all your sins, then you reach in the point that that you have no sins and your sins will be wiped off. And this is, so it is degrees. But everyone has a certain qualification, certain rewards. Then also al-ghufran, wal-af, wal-mahw. That's all of them, but it all goes to your forgiving your sins, wiping off your sins, and erasing your sins. So, but in that matter, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all this together. Because when you ask Allah for forgiveness, you get rewards for asking. And you will get forgiven, so you get two things. Your sins will be forgiven, you will get reward also for asking, for supplicating for forgiveness. And this it comes from verses from the Quran Kareem, and also same from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will like you to have hope. So they will promise you for forgiveness, and also will when you commit a sin, will have you content. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, you will be forgiven. And this because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-ghafoor, al-ghaffar. Verses from the Quran Kareem, like number one, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 58. With قُلْنَا دُخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا وَادْخُلُوا الْبَيْتَ سُجَّدًا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا وَقُولُوا حِطَّةٌ نَغْفُرْ لَكُمْ خَطَائِيَاكُمْ وَسَنَزِيدُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ نَغْفُرْ لَكُمْ خَطَائِيَاكُمْ. So he's telling the people, that of Bani Israel, to go for what the Prophet Musa asked him to go, to enter the village, the city, the Jerusalem. You're going to eat whatever you want, and your life will be prosperous, and supplicate, and make sujood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins, and even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have extra rewards for the people who are the people of the Muhsineen. Also, in another verse, which is Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 173, إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتَةَ وَالدَّمَ وَلَحْمَ الْخِنْزِيرَ وَمَا أُهِلَّ بِهِ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ فَمَنُ اضْطُرَّ غَيْرَ بَاغٍ وَلَا عَادٍ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Also, when you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid on us certain food, which is the dead, cannot eat the dead, we cannot eat the blood, we drink the blood, we cannot eat the meat of the khanzir, the pig, and you also cannot eat whatever been slaughtered in somebody else other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have to, it's the reason that you eat halal. This is the halal food that you eat. Unless you are desperate, unless your life is threatened. When your life is threatened, you keep your life. You stay alive by eating whatever to keep your life to the minimum to keep yourself alive. So when you are in a situation that you have nothing else other than to eat what's forbidden, you eat it just to keep yourself alive. Again, إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So always keep in mind that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most merciful. And also, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 182, فَمَنْ خَافَ مِنْ مُوسٍ جَنَفًا أَوْ إِثْمًا فَأَصْلَحْ بَيْنَهُمْ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most forgiving and the most merciful. Another verse, which is Surah Al-Baqarah 268, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. Look at this. The devil promise you with poverty and order you to do the wrong doings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promising you with forgiveness and blessing and more. Wallahu wasi'un alim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most knowledgeable. Look how you have choices. You have a choice. Clear that the devil promised you poverty, promised you the worst thing in you're going to live like a slave to the devil, and he's going to order you the wrongdoings, all this wrong side. Why you go there? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise you with forgiveness and promise you with prosperity, with knowledge. So how come you choose the wrong side and you have this side which is going to be good for you? So this is when you compare that devil is not going to forgive you. Devil is going to take you to the wrong side, and at the end he's going to stay away from, leave you alone. And he say, I order you and you obeyed me, but I know that what I'm doing wrong, what you did wrong, is going to give up on you and going to leave you alone, but you are not going to be excused because you have the choice. The choice is following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, or the choice of following the devil's poverty. And poverty is not only for money. You can poverty in other things, because not the poverty only related to the money. But the devil, when he guides, to the wrong side, the poverty, the wrongdoings, the all the wicked things that you are not going to contend. You are not going to be happy. You will never be happy when you go to with the devil. Because always the devil going to like enslave you. But when you be the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a higher rank. This is the best rank that you can get. Oh, the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, described Prophet Muhammad as his slave. And this is the highest rank, to be the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created you. He knows what's good for you to follow. And when you follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are in the right side, in the content side of your life. So this is what you should follow, forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another verse, Surah Al-Imran, verse 155, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا مِنْكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ ببعض ما كسبوا ولقد عفى الله عنهم إن الله غفور رحيم. Look at this. Even in what happened when the believers they walked away from the battlefield, because the devil showed them, this is good for you not to stay, walk away. what after they got what he got, what they got. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the believers of that because they did not realize, they did not know. But after that, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that they're going to stay on the right side after knowing the reality of what they have done. So أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. من سورة النساء verse 23 Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us what's forbidden for Muslims not to do in the matter of their relationship with you and your family or your the woman that you, in your life. So it's forbidden. حرمت عليكم أمهاتكم وبناتكم وأخواتكم وعماتكم وخالاتكم وبنات الأخ وبنات الأخت أمهاتكم التي أرضعنكم وأخواتكم من الرضاعة وأمهات نسائكم وربائبكم التي في حجوركم من نسائكم التي دخلتم بهن فإن لم تكونوا دخلتم بهن فلا جناح عليكم وحلائل أبنائكم الذين من أصلابكم وإن تجمعوا بين الأختين إلا ما قد سلف إن الله غفور رحيم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, but he's telling you what's forbidden for you. The forbidden to marry your mother, marry your daughter, to marry your sisters, to marry your aunt, to marry from your father's side, your mother's side, and the daughter of your nieces, or from your brother, the nieces from your sister, and also the mother that who suckling you, and the brothers or sisters from your suckling, and the mother of your wives. And so all this, the Quran al-Kareem is open book for all the right to do, all the wrong to stay away. And still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most forgiving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the one who forgive all the sins. So staying away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness all the time, for Allah to have, subhanahu wa ta'ala will have shield between you and the wrong doings to stay away from. In Surah النساء verse 95 and 96 لا يستوي القاعدون من المؤمنين غير أولي الضرر والمجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالهم وأنفسهم فضل الله المجاهدين بأموالهم وأنفسهم على القاعدين درجة وكلا وعد الله الحسنى وفضل الله المجاهدين على القاعدين أجرا عظيما درجات منه ومغفرة ورحمة وكان الله غفورا رحيم. Now, the believers, the sitting believers that who do nothing, they are not like the believers who go and fight for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they work hard to be self-sufficient, to support their families. When they spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they give their lives, they give their wealth for sabilillah. So the people who fight for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who give, spend charities, spend for sabilillah, they are in a better degree than the one who is sitting doing nothing. So this is encouragement for you to spend for the sake of Allah, not only your money, but also your time, your wealth, your knowledge. So if you have something, give. So when you give, you're going to feel happiness with the feeling of giving, the content of giving, the happiness of giving is much better than having the happiness of taking. So this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you what to do, what you have, and still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most forgiving and the most merciful. Also, on the other hand, in Surah Surah An-Nisa, also in الَّذِينَ تَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ ظَالِمِي أَنفُسِهُمْ قَالُوا فِيمَ كُنْتُمْ قَالُوا كُنَّا مُسْتَضْعَفِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ قَالُوا أَلَمْ تَكُنْ أَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً فَتُهَاجِرُوا فِيهَا فَأُولَئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمُ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا إِلَّا مُسْتَضْعَفِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ وَالْوِلْدَانِ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ حِيلَةً وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ سَبِيلًا فَأُولَئِكَ عَسَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَعْفُوَ عَنْهُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَفُوًّا غَفُورًا. Now the people who in a situation that they cannot do good for themselves because they are under oppression of others. They did not explore to go away, to migrate, to stay away from the oppressors. And they did the wrong things because of that, the oppressors was forcing them to do the wrong things. But then when they are asked why they didn't go away and do the right things, they said they were just weak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will just forgive whoever that he knows really that they have no choice. But still, if you are under oppression of somebody, ardullahi wasa'a, the land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wide open for you to explore other opportunities to do the wrong things. It means that if you have bad companions that they oppress you to do wrongs and invite you to do wrongs and you under their control you to do wrongs, and then you say, what a choice I have. No, you have a choice to leave them, to go to the good companions that they will remind you to prayers, remind you to charity, remind you to do good things. So you have a choice here. So don't be under this oppression of the wrongdoers to do wrongs. No, seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be with the good side. وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعَةً وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثم يدركه الموت فقد وقع أجره على الله وكان الله غفورا رحيما. When you immigrate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you seek to do the right things and to improve your life, and also only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if you die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have you in His sight, and your good reward, seeing that you will be like a shaheed when you die away from your home, when you migrate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most forgiving, the most merciful. This will be a long ethic here that we're going to address for several khutbah. So inshallah we'll continue on next khutbah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. Oh Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart and spirit. Oh Allah, do not let our heart deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and the of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and of my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and at all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي للصلاة حي للفلاة قادة الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله إلا الله.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا وسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله.